spine is basically broken.
We also see the object that hit her bounce off her head. His pose suggests someone who has just used force.
There are camera angles that are completely improbable. And we know this because we have surveillance footage that has been smuggled out of China during the Battle of Tiananmen, so to speak, and they're nothing like this. This one is dramatic. Every camera angle is set up ahead of time, or so it seems. One of the figures is sitting there and appears to be wearing something protective on his face. We have the supposed burn victims in full body casts.
I drank about a half bottle and they wanted to pour the rest on my body.
We would not expect that the press or the news media in general would keep a very close eye on the central government, which is the source of all power in China.
Was the Chinese New Year's, right? And everybody knew there would be some kind of demonstration of some sort. There always is. It had become routine. To use burning, monks have used it as a form of protest. It's been done for centuries. That's not new. As an entity, did Falun Gong decide to do this? No, we know that's not true. We do know that the circumstances were extremely suspicious. We know that at least a couple of the people who were there that day were not practitioners.
If the media as a whole is closely allied with the government, the function or the purpose of being a government watchdog will be losing out.
It is an instinct response from the Chinese Communist government to suppress, crack down the Falun Gong.
There's no any chance or any free hand given to the media as far as Falun Gong is concerned.
Because the Falun Gong seems pose a threat to the dictatorship of the Communist Party.
As far as we know, he's seen as an enemy.
Though Falun Gong said that it will not be involved in any politics and it's just a religion, but the Communist Party want to believe it.
Pursuit Falun Gong in every way they can.
If some of the evidence mentioned today to say Falun Gong has a tendency to commit suicide, we do not find this kind of examples in United States, Europe, or other foreign Falun Gong practitioners.
I do have a big problem with cults. I don't care for them. I actually had some contact with one when I was younger through my first girlfriend. I've never forgotten it and how grotesque everything seemed to me. Falun Gong does not meet any of those qualifications. Because it doesn't break up families. The key thing about a cult is that it has to break up the family structure. The most powerful human structure we know. It must destroy it, it must weaken it.
I've met practitioners in 30 countries now. We've been to 30 countries and I have enormous respect for people who practice Falun Gong.
In authoritarian governments, the government is controlled by very little. It controls rather than being controlled, and is certainly not controlled by public opinion, except to a very limited extent. Whereas democratic governments both control and are controlled by public opinion.
I would ask those who call Falun Gong as an evil cult to come up and say, what do they mean by evil cult? And by that definition, can say also point their finger to many other organizations, even including the Communist Party, as an evil cult.
When it came to power, it has never stopped persecuting the religious group. And to maintain its unique, its sole influence, political influence in China.
The reason why the government was scared is because it could not control their minds. It could not ask them to do things because they were not dealing with people who were indoctrinated, they were dealing with people who were touched by freedom and by the realization that to some extent there was another truth and the government was not conveying the truth.
Incidentally, I know there's somebody here from the Chinese media. Every word that the gentleman at the back of the room from the Xinhua news agency writes has to be approved by an editor, a party editor. In other words, he can go back after this meeting and write a very fair story, and everything in that article which is fair is subject to review by a party editor.
In China, it's completely different from the West. Like the freedom of information or the freedom of acquiring information, the freedom is just take for granted. But in China, there's no such freedom at all.
The media in China is an utter, total disaster, despite, I'm sure, the efforts of such as the man at the back of the room.
We only have one voice, the voice from the government, from the party. So everybody has to listen and to believe it, because there's no other information source.
They say it is a bad thing. Refuse to eat anything. It will teach people to suicide. And they will burn themselves. Is it the same as what you know?
Chinese government was amazed by the resilience of Falun Gong, by its quietness, by its astounding way to attract sympathizers and adherents, and its use of the electronic media.
They thought there is something to do with the power, with something like that, but in fact, it is not.
I lived in China for 26 years. I understood, you know, pretty clearly what kind of regime the Chinese Communist Party is, and I understood how they would treat those practitioners inside China.
What the government of China has done to the Falun Gong community, I think, is very similar to what the government of Rwanda did to the Tutsi community in the media, or at least the party media. Before the terrible genocide there of April to June of 94.
How they would treat the Chinese people as a whole.
We've seen it happen in Bosnia. Darfur is just another example. When an unprincipled dictatorial government decides they're going to target a community, they are very, unfortunately, they're very clever and sweeping people up.
The morality of a human being is very much depend on how we, you know, behave when we have this kind of, you know, serious situation, just like World War II, when those people in the Nazi Germany. When you face those evil regime, you know, if we just keep silent, and then they're going to, you know, keep the power all the time, and a human being will be like destroyed in the end. So we have to stand up in these kind of situations.
In fact, it's one of the things that makes the West begin to notice as well. I know a British producer who was in China not too long after the Chongqing incident. He was told not to film anybody watching a television set, because his Chinese handlers, were afraid that they would catch a hijacking in progress.
So if Falun Gong is not an evil cult, then Falun Gong should deserve the rights to enjoy religious freedoms, as many other religions do today.
There's been seen by the central government as a political sin for the member as well as the organization of Falun Gong.
Some people ask, are Falun Gong practitioners getting political? Here's my thought on this. And this is a delicate situation here. Could you imagine if it was your personal...